So, hello everyone. So today we are going to complete the rest of the job. So previously you have seen, right? We have created jobs for compilation, correct? And we have done with the code review, right? So today we'll be creating the job for unit test, metric check, package, and then we'll deploy the tar file and var file to the application, or you can say Tomcat server, or it's a Nginx server, fine.
Yeah.
So let me start the instance. So your server is up and running. So we'll take the public IP and we'll connect to the Jenkins server. Just take this IP with here. Okay. Colon 8080. Okay. Login to admin. Admin. Fine. At the same time, I'll log into the GitHub as well. Okay. So this is our local repository which I have created, that is demo Abhishek repo. But for the live project which we are doing is, that is your GitHub or address book, right? Correct, guys? So this is that
Yes.
your live project, that is your address book, fine. So coming back to here, okay. So this dashboard, you can see that we have created the jobs for your compilation, that is your compile address book, and that is the next one is, that is your code review, correct? So in the code review, why we have created for code review, Manranjan and Pawan? We have created for the code review because if you want to check the syntax of that particular code, then you need to do the code review for that code, right? And as you saw the goals we have set it is PMD, and the plugins is required to understand that report is PMD only, right? So if you go here, so you can see in the left corner, there is PMD warning. So yesterday you have seen those XML files we cannot read. So for that, we require to install PMD plugin, right? So now we can see
Yes.
the results. So we can see that what all errors are there. So we can fix it those errors, right? Correct? Fine. So as I told previously also, once we're done with all the creation of jobs, then only we'll go ahead and schedule your timer and your poll SCM, right? And your upstream and
Yeah.
your downstream. Correct, guys? So here,
Yes.
so what I'll do first is I'm going to create another job, okay, and that job name is going to be unit test, right, guys? Correct? So you need to mention unit test
Test.
address book, right?
Yeah.
This is correct?
Freestyle project.
Yes. We'll go with the freestyle. Click on OK. So as soon as you'll be getting into the configuration part, what you need to do next is you need to give the SCM, that is your Git URL. So what is your Git URL? You can clone it from here, right? You can copy the URL and you can put it over here. Okay, fine. So once you're done with this one, what next we need to do, guys? We need to click on build, right? So under build, you need to click on top level Maven, right? So here you need to select your Maven name and the goal. So as I told, your goal is very much important here. So what is the goal for this unit test? So first you need to tell me why we are doing unit test.
You have to check the entire strength of the project.
Yes, exactly. We need to check the entire strength of the project. This is why we are doing the unit test. So it's not only going to check some classes or some file. Entire strength of your code means this phase of this particular life cycle of your Jenkins is very much important, because your entire code is dependent upon this unit test. If this gets failed, then you need to revert back to your developer. Correct, guys? Okay. So here you can see, and the goal we need to set is test only. So there is nothing required, no other parameter we need to set it up here. Okay. Just you need to mention test. So let me check once, verify once again. So if there is any other parameter we need to set, it means for the goal. So we need to set those parameters over here. Okay. So here in the unit test, only test is required. That's it. Okay. So we can type it also. So just in a small case, you need to type test. That's fine. Okay. So once you done with this one, okay, what next we need to do? Do we need to configure the post build action? Do we need to configure this build environment? Do we need to click on this build trigger? Nothing, right? What we need to do next is you just need to apply and save, right? Correct, guys? And then what you need to do is you need to build the job. So your job will be executed. So how you can check the logs for that job is, just check the take this particular IP, okay, log into that server. Okay, go to this desktop, go to okay, keep here Mumbai key, you need to select here, go to the session and click on this. Okay, so Ubuntu, password is sudo hyphen -i. Okay, okay, guys. Okay, so you just need to tell app which logs, audit logs, audit trial logs.
Yeah.
Correct. Where is that?
Yes.
Under temp, right?
Yeah. Audit
so logs. Yes. It's completed with success, right? This one. I think it's running only. Or let me check it's running or what it's going on with that job which we are building. So it's still it's building, right? It's taking time because it's a yeah. So now you can see it's completed. Okay, console. Just check here. So at the bottom you can see it's completed success. With success, right? Correct. Here also you might have seen that it's completed, right? This is some different job. Okay, so that's fine. That's not an issue. Okay, so now coming back to understand. Okay, so as I said, so once you'll be, your job is built for unit test, your goal is set and you have built the job, but if you want to understand the report, means that job will generate a report, right? So you need to understand the report that your strength of the code is strong, that much strong enough that it should bear the load for the application, right? Correct. So if suppose 5 lakhs people are hitting your code, so whether it will be able to bear that load or not, right? So that we need to check it before only. Okay, guys. So what we need to do is we need to go here under workspace. You need to check some file. That file is very much important. Okay. So if you go to under this target, you will be getting different directories. Okay, but you need to go under this Surefire report. Okay, for unit test, there are multiple reports will be there, not only single report. Remember, guys. Again, I am telling you. So for this particular unit test job, there will be multiple files, multiple XML files you'll be getting. Okay, so it should not be only one single file. So for that, what you need to do is you need to take all these XML files and you need to provide the all these XML file path in the post built action, correct? But before to that one, which plugin you need to install? You need to install the plugin called JUnit. Understanding my point, guys? See, again, yes. I'm explaining. Okay. Again, I'm explaining for the unit test, the goal is test, correct? The goal is test, but the plugin to understand that report is JUnit. Okay. To understand that report, you need to give the path of that particular XML files. So what will be the path for that XML file is that is target surefire reports star.xml. Why I am taking star.xml? Because here you can see this is the path target surefire report and slash, right? So under this you have multiple files over here, right? So you cannot take a single file. If I click on any of these single files, you won't be getting any output. So what you need to do is whichever XML files are there, because these text files are not your report. So only these files, your report will be there. So how we are going to read this one? Then you need to take all the XML files. So you need to set the path under post built action. So for that, what we need to do, guys, we need to click on configure. Just go to this post build action. Here you need to select which plugin. Are you able to see any JUnit plugin over here? No, right? Correct, Manoranjan, Pavan, both of you?
Yeah, no.
No, the reason is because we haven't installed the plugin that is called JUnit. Understanding these only interview questions, they'll ask you. If in depth, they'll ask you. Not depth, they'll that much they'll ask you. But in depth, they might be asking you. Okay. So what we need to do is we need to click on Jenkins, correct? Just leave this page as of now. Just go to this Jenkins, go to manage Jenkins. Under manage Jenkins, where we need to go, guys? We need to go to the manage plugins. Under manage plugins, where we need to check? Under available. What plugin we need to check? JUnit, correct?
So JUnit.
Yeah. So are you able to see anything related to JUnit? It is there, right?
JUnit assessment.
But there is also one thing called JUnit real time test recorder, right? This is also there, right?
Yes.
So which one I need to choose? Just read this one first. So read the first one, what it's telling. Jenkins plugin parent. Tell me, guys, which plugin I'll install for POM. POM is for your
reporter one.
No, POM is for your Maven, right? That's what I said. POM is your for Maven and JUnit test result reporter plugin created Jira issue directly from Jenkins and linking them to JUnit test, right? That is Jira test. This is, and the other one is JUnit real time test reporter. Correct. So we need to go with this JUnit real time test reporter. Understanding my guys, my point, guys. Pavan, Manoranjan, both of you.
Can you repeat again?
So what I am telling is here you will be getting two types of plugin, right? So one plugin is telling JUnit attachments, correct? The JUnit attachment is the Jenkins plugin parent POM project, correct? So are we building any POM project which is related? No, right? We are doing PMD, right?
No. Yes. Right? Yes.
So yes. Which plugin we need to use here is JUnit
runtime test reporter.
Correct, Manojan, you are able to understand. Manojan, you are there?
Yeah, I'm able to understand.
Okay, that's fine. So we need to install this particular plugin. Okay. So let me install this plugin and let's see that we are able to get the report or not. Okay, guys. Is there any other JUnit name decoder is there? No. So these two are there, which is more. Or before going into this one, just check in the installed also. That is also important. Okay, just go here. Just type JUnit. Is there anything related to JUnit? So you can see JUnit plugin here also. It is mentioned, right? In the installed. Correct? Correct, guys? Okay. So we'll go ahead and we'll install the first one which we have discussed. That is JUnit. Okay. Install without restart. Okay. So once you're done with installation, what we need we need to do is we need to click on unit test, click on this configure, go to post build action. Okay, under this post build action, now you'll be getting JUnit related something. It's something related to coming as a JUnit here.
Yeah, publish JUnit test result. Go up.
Yeah, this one, right? Yeah. Publish JUnit test result. Correct? Now it's coming. Correct?
Yeah.
So here, once you get this one, So once you get this one, what path we need to give it here, guys?
SRC, something is there.
No, target slash sure fire report. They'll ask you for JUnit. What should be the path or what is that report file? What is the XML file is for that JUnit? Sometimes they'll ask you in the interview if they want to go in depth. So which plugin is required, they'll ask you. That is fine. You can set JUnit. But what path we need to set it means which file it's going to read. So that file name is Surefire report. Okay. Understand once again. The file, the XML file will be Surefire report. Okay. So you need to give that entire path and you need to remember this particular file XML, that particular report name. That is called Surefire slash star dot XML. Correct? So this entire path you need to give it here. Okay. If you go here also you'll be getting something like test report, something they will tell you, but you need to include this one. That's it. Okay. Now what we need to do is you need to apply and you need to save. Done. So what we need to do next is you need to build the job.
Build now.
So your job is built now. So now you can check the console output. So you can see it's completed with success. Correct, guys?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So what we need to see that? We need to see the report, right? So you can see in the left corner, there is something called test result, right? That is your plugin, JUnit, and your test result you need, right? So you can see here. Okay. So you can see clearly how many failures are there. This is the entire strength of your code. So it's telling that total failure is zero and skip is zero. So out of plus 23 parameters, might be it has taken some 23 parameters and 23 parameters it has passed all of them. So your this entire code is this entire package. This code is what? Different packages will be there or packages there, right? So this entire package, if it is showing some 11 pass or 50% of the it's telling okay pass and this much is fail, then also you need to inform to your developer, because this particular phase you should be informed to your developer that this is very much important, because this particular job, it's going to check the entire strength of your code, correct? Not only not something related to your class functions or files, right? So this is why it is very much important. So if any failure is there, if one or two failure, yes, we can ignore, we can avoid, we can go ahead with the deployment. But if the failure is more than some 50% or something, then you need to inform to the developer. Okay? Correct? Coming back to the Jenkins dashboard. So we have done with creating our three jobs. Correct? So you can see that we have created compile, we have created the code review. Now we have created the unit test. So what will be the next job we need to create is your metrics check. So let's start and create the metrics check. So for this one, same way only you need to do is you need to click here. You just mention metric. CHKADDR. Okay. Just give it okay. Give the SCM URL over here. Copy it. Click here. Just give it here. Okay. Next is your build. Top level Maven. Under this, the Maven name you need to provide and the goal. So what is the goal for your metrics check is Cobertura.
Cobertura.
Cobertura is the goal, you need to put it over here. Okay. So Cobertura, there is a special syntax, same way which we have done it for code review. We need to provide as a goal. So Cobertura, the syntax here, it's very much important. That is Cobertura colon Cobertura hyphen D Cobertura dot report dot format equal to XML. Okay, so this particular goal you need to set it over there. Okay guys, so just put this syntax should be very much correct. Okay, they might have asked, they'll ask you what is the goal for your metrics check. So you need to tell Cobertura colon Cobertura hyphen D Cobertura report format equal to XML. Okay, so what next we need to do is you need to apply, you need to save, right? And you need to build the job, right? So once you build the job, just check here it's running or not, right? You started a job over here, metrics check ADDR, correct? Started. So just wait for a few minutes. Okay, so you can see the job is built now. So if you want to see the output, then console output, and you need to go to the bottom and you need to see it's finished with success, right? Correct, guys? So once you have done with this one, so where we need to go again? Go to the job and you need to check under workspace, right? You need to find the file, that XML file. So now for this particular job, for your metrics check, so why we are doing metrics check, guys? So we are doing metrics check because you want to check the strength of your each and every module. Correct? So what is your module? So your module can be your files, your classes, your functions, your methods, your different things will be there, right? If any problem with your function, with any of your classes, then that has to be informed to the development team, or you can say to the engineering team. Correct? Correct, guys?
Yes.
So under metric check, you know you have done, right? You have created your job, you have set your goal, but you need to understand the report once again. So it's going to generate a report, right? That report we need to understand. So how we are going to understand that report? So for that, you need to install a plugin called Cobertura, and the file which is responsible to give the report is your coverage.xml. Okay, the file name which is responsible to give the report result, that is your coverage.xml. Okay, so under this target, you will be getting site/Cobertura. Under this, you will be getting this Cobertura. That under Cobertura, you will be getting coverage.xml. Understanding my point, guys? So this is the file, okay, which will be giving the report result for your metrics check. Okay.
And I think this path we have to provide, right?
Yeah, this path we need to provide. That is true. So this is XML file, so we can't read this file, correct? So if you want to understand this file, then what we need to do is you need to install which plugin? Cobertura, correct? To understand the report, to understand the coverage.xml report, you need to install, or either indirectly they'll ask. They'll not ask, okay, for this metric check, what plugin we need to install. Might be they'll ask to understand the coverage.xml, which plugin is required. So you need to tell Cobertura. You are getting my point, guys, correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
Or vice versa also they can ask. Those questions will be there. Okay. So coming back to this Jenkins. Under this Jenkins, what you need to do is you need to go to this manage Jenkins. Under manage Jenkins, you need to go to manage plugins. Under manage plugins, under this, you need to search for Cobertura.
Cobertura.
Correct, guys? So you can see there is something called Cobertura. The plugin integrate Cobertura coverage report, right? So it's very clear. So you need to install this one without restart. Just install this one. Just wait for a few seconds. It will install successfully. Then we need to get back to the Jenkins dashboard. From there, you need to click on metrics check, right? Job.
Cobertura is installed.
Yeah, so it is installed now. So you can go ahead and you can click on this metrics check. Under this, what you need to do is you need to again go to the configure and you need to click on post build action. Correct, guys? And you need to check that Cobertura is yes. So you can see publish Cobertura coverage report, right? It's came now. So what we need to give it to here, you need to give the path over here.
Path.
So the path for this metrics check will be your, is there or not? One second. Install plugin.
Not there.
It is not there, right?
No.
Target/site/ Cobertura.
No, we need to give the exact. That is correct only. We need to give it to like this also. Okay, if you go here, CD. Okay, where live? Okay. Jenkins. CD workspace. Okay. Under this, you have metrics check, right? Okay. So.
But here it's showing no files.
No, that is CD I have typed twice, right? So under okay, this okay. target is there. Under okay. target you have
site.
Where is that?
Site.
Right. Here it is.
Last.
And then under this Kovacura. You have Kovacura, right? You have coverage.xml, correct? So what yeah. you need to do is you yes. just need to do pwd and you need to take it from here. Okay. Yeah. And mm-hmm. come here. Okay. So this is other way you can take it, exact syntax. Okay. And what you need to give is just copy yeah. this coverage.xml. Okay. And put it over here. Okay. Understanding my point, guys? Clear?
Yes.
Clear. What yes. we need to do is you just need to apply and you need to save it.
Save.
Okay. So the job is saved now. Okay. What is happening?
Go back to the browser.
Okay, so you can see it's there. Okay. Fine. So under this, we have already said the again. If you want to check, then we need to go and we need to see that it's configured properly or not. Go to post build action. Here, you need to click on Kovacura, so you can see the path is not at all set, right? So you need to set it once again. Slash. Okay. Apply it and save it.
To add that coverage.xml.
Go to this matrix, check again. Okay. So here you can see this one, it's already there. This also you can copy and do it. No need to go and do it again and again. Correct? So just click on apply and save it. Okay. So you can see it's done. And now what we need to do next is you need to click on build now, right? So just wait for a few seconds. Okay. So guys, you understand how we can get it, right? If you forgot the path or something.
Yes.
So from the back end, how we can get it, right?
Yes.
Fine, so you can see the job is built now. Okay, so it's getting slow. My internet connection might be because of that. Click on this console output. So you can see it's completed with success. Okay, so what next you need to do is, at the left corner, you can see there is something called coverage report, right? So if you click on this one, so you'll be getting the coverage report. So here you can see, for this is very much important, understand this one. Okay. So as I said, this particular job is going to check each and every module of your strength, strength of each and every module, right? So what is these modules are there? Okay, so what will be the file name? XML file name is your coverage.xml. Which plugin is required to understand this report is Coverchura, right? And the goal we need to set it is this Coverchura: dcoverchura.report.format=XML, right, guys? Understanding my point?
Yes.
So coming back to here, so you can see packages is there, files are there, classes are there, methods are there, lines are there, conditions are there. So if it is green or it's showing some 25%, 31%, 29%, 22%, then also we can maintain this one, right? So it's completely fine. I don't think so any issue with this one.